I Have a executive session, same night, April 19, 2015.
Your motion.
Motion, now second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Item five, Acknowledgements, Proclamation, Resolution. City of Cumming Business Ranking. We have, James McCoy here with the Chamber. Bring us up today on some good news for the City of Cumming and South County.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, good evening. Thank you for, giving a few moments on the agenda this evening. Recently, both the Atlanta Business Chronicle and Forsyth County News, reported that an organization, they have a funny name, but they do very serious work, called Nerd Wallet. They took a look at communities around Georgia, and identified the ones that were the best places to start a business. And I'm very glad to say that the City of Cumming ranked number six on that list. When you get down into the criteria of what it means to be on that list, it's very, very good news. It reflects a really strong and vibrant economy for the City of Cumming and our community. It's important to note that we're also one of the smallest communities on the list. We go through the list. We're one of the smaller ones. And I thought it was also important that they noted that there are almost as many businesses operating in Cumming as there are people. And that was an exciting bit of news and a rarity in the cities as well. And they also noted, of course, the technology infrastructure that the City of Cumming has in our location, 4400, and the overall business environment, including the regulatory environment. As you all have heard me say many, many times before, the City of Cumming, in our view, certainly most business-friendly in the state, and this gives us some credence to that as well. So congratulations to you all. That the work that you've done for many years is really paying off, so we appreciate that and opportunity.
Thank you very much, Jane. Appreciate you bringing that information. This board started making plans for this kind of growth a long time ago, maybe back in the 80s. We went and reached an intergovernmental agreement with the Forsyth County on the wastewater and sewer, and we started planning for that. And over the years, the city has built infrastructure, not only the water and sewer, but streets and roads, and work for business, try to be a business-friendly community. So we've put a lot of hard work and dedication in being number six, and hopefully we can climb from there. Again, thank you very much for that information.
Thank you.
Item six, administration, we have personnel policy and senior manual revision. Phil. Yeah, Phil, you want to bring us up to date in reference to the policy and procedures manual?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Mayor and City Council. Last month, you were presented with proposed changes to the City of Cumming personnel policies and procedures manual. These changes were recommended by city staff and reviewed by legal counsel, and I'm here tonight to answer any questions you may have and ask your consideration to adopt this document.
This was handed out to last meeting for information only. This is the policy and procedures manual for your review and to be adopted tonight. Answer any questions, as Phil says, who's Director of Department of Human Resources. If everybody's had a chance to look at that and want to adopt it tonight, if you want to postpone it or whatever pleasure of the board. I have a motion from John D. that the recommendation of Phil Higgins to adopt personnel policy and procedures manual.
I second
from Ryan. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Phil.
Thank you.
I know it took a lot of hard work and dedication to put the manual together, but appreciate y'all working on it.
Yes, sir.
Item seven, new business, planning and zoning. Item one is annexation request number 201-5198, Clearland Properties LLC. Scott Martin, Director of Planning and Zoning.
Yes, sir, thank you, Mayor, members of the council. If I could, please direct your attention to the staff report. In fact, I'd like to read it into the record. The property owner has made application to the proper authorities to annex two parcels located at and adjacent to 1087 Grove, totaling 5 acres, more or less in the city limits, and rezone them to city office professional. Properties are more specifically identified as tax map 173, parcel 011, and tax map 173, parcel 362. Track 173011 currently contains an office building, and track 173362 is vacant. The planning board did hold a public hearing on May 19th, 2015, and with no opposition to the present board, the unanimously recommend approval of the annexation and rezoning to office professional. To the best of our knowledge, the proposed annexation and rezoning will not result in loss of value, use, or enjoyment of adjacent property owners. Proposed annexation and rezoning is in conformance with the city future land use and comprehensive plans. And you have in your packet a letter from the county attorney that the Forsyth County said they had no objection to proposed annexation. Therefore, the recommendation is for approval for the two parcels to be annexed and rezoned to office professional. I'll be happy to answer any questions in this matter. Mayor will require a public hearing.
We need a public hearing, correct?
Yes, sir, we do. Yeah.
Council, have any questions? Okay. I hear a motion. We open up a public hearing.
So motion.
Have a motion. Have a second?
Second.
Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Thank you. Anybody here like to speak in favor of the annexation request of Clearland Properties 201-5198? Anybody here like to speak in opposition? Clearing properties 205-201-5198. Hear motion to close public hearing.
Second.
Motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, this is located 1080 Sanders Road, is that correct?
Yes, sir. The office building is on the parcel.
Yes, and the proximity to get my bearing right. This would kind of be in behind the Home Depot,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, that's what I was going to say. These parcels back up to the Home Depot property.
And this was 5.1 acres.
It's actually total is 5 acres even in parcels.
This is commercial.
It is requested rezoning to office professional. Which we have some properties that we recently annexed on Sanders Road further up there that also office professional. So.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the board?
Thank you.
I have a motion from John D. to approval of the annexation request 201-5198. Have a second?
Second.
Second from Rand. Any discussion?
Could we also include that as both annexation and rezoning to office professional?
All at the same time.
I'll
need to be put together. Would that be zoning? Would we amend that to add the zoning office profession? Right here, would that be amendment? Have a motion and a second. I guess I need amendment for that. Have a motion from Ralph to amend it to office profession. Have a second to the amendment. Okay. Cheryl, hold on the right of the main motion to annexation first. I have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Now the amendment to office profession. Zoning. Have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, item two is rezoning request number 201-5183, 3R Leasing LLC. Scott.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Again, I direct direct your attention to the fact that the staff report on this rezoning request. The property owner has made application to the proper authorities to rezone 207 Talbot Street, consisting of 1.1 acres more or less from institutional zoning to restricted industrial A1. Property is more specifically identified as tax map COA parcel 098. The property is currently vacant, and a commercial office warehouse facility will be constructed. The planning board held a public hearing on May 19th, 2015, and with no opposition, president recommended approval of the rezoning request with the condition that the new commercial office warehouse facility will have a brick or masonry front. To the best of our knowledge, the proposed rezoning will not result in the loss of value use or enjoyment to the adjacent property owners. The proposed rezoning is in conformance with the city of Cumming future land use and comprehensive plans. Therefore, we do have a recommendation of approval for the rezoning with the condition that we rezoning to restricted industrial with the condition that the new commercial office warehouse facility will have a brick or masonry front, and the structure, of course, will comply with all other accessibility, building code, zoning requirements, setbacks, so forth. We're happy to answer any questions on this, and once again, there is this will also be a public hearing.
Okay. Any questions? Thanks, Scott.
Yes, sir.
Your motion open for public hearing.
Make a motion.
Have a second.
Second.
Motion and second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anybody here would like to speak in favor? Zoning rezoning request 2015183. Anybody would like to speak in opposition? Zoning request 2015183. Hear motion to close public hearing.
Make a motion.
Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. What's the pleasure of the board? I said, I hear a motion. I'll go ahead, Scott.
That's right. I was going to ask for motion.
I have a motion. Sorry. The rezoning request, Dundee.
Yeah.
Have a second.
Yeah.
Second. Quincy, in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Scott.
That is.
Item B, request advertised for payment of various city streets. This is a little bit unusual, but the city engineers, which is Marvin Atabella, they have recommended that the city do some street paving, and we didn't budget for these streets. We'd like to advertise for bids to see what the cost is, and let the engineer decide which one needs to come first, because we have a situation now that we could lose some streets. It's real bad shape if we don't do some paving, and about what money that we would use would have to come out of contingency fund probably on these roads. So I hear a motion in reference to the advertising.
We're good. We advertise and go out for bids for repaving streets.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to go out for bids for these streets, and we have Director of the Roads here, and I don't know where Mr. Hugh Bowden wants to add anything, but we do have some streets that's in bad dire need of some work. I know you told us that, and you may want to deliberate on that a little bit.
We only have estimates as to the cost, and that's the purpose of this bidding process. We'd like to get these bids in so we'll know what we can do with the monies that are available now and the monies that will come available.
Thank you. Have a motion and a second to advertise for the streets and that be determined by more than that bet. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Item C, request advertise bids for intake generator with raw water intake of Lake Premier's. John Hurd, Director of Utilities.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, and members of the City Council. As you know, we've been working diligently for a couple of years to come up with an intergovernmental agreement for Side County to purchase a raw water generator for intake that we have on Lake Premier and We've come up with IGAs designed by the county and the city, so the funds have become available for us to go out for bids for this piece of equipment. So we're requesting that you allow us, we have an engineering design, we have an electrical engineer, the generator. This is a 4160 volt generator, so it's sort of different from the 480 volt generators that we have most of our other locations. So we have an electrical engineer come over to design, and we'd like to go out for bids and bring those bids back to you at the next council meeting.
Okay, have a request of Department Utilities Director for advertised bid for the intake generator for the raw water intake. And basically, this is to take the place of the parish system if it goes down. The generator will enable us to keep pumping water.
That's correct. We have two 900 horsepower pumps and one 450 and one 400 horsepower pump. And this generator will run all four of those pumps and enable the city to provide raw water not only to the city's drinking water treatment plant, but also to Kim's drinking water treatment plant.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the board to hear a motion?
I would like a motion.
Got a motion to have a second? Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Item two, request advertised bid for a sit-down creek trunk sewer line. John Durr.
Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, as you're aware, we've been working on a wastewater pumping station on sit-down creek. And that's a very large drainage basin. It's our northernmost portion of our sewer service area. It's about 7,000 acres in the area. It's everything north of Song Mountain. It goes up Highway 369 over Doc Brown Road. And so everything that, when it rains, all of that land drains to just one point of Sedgown Creek. So we've begun the process of sewering that area. And we're building the pumping station, we're building the force main right now. And those are getting close to completion. By the end of the summer. What we're requesting now is to be able to extend the gravity sewer line up to John Burris Road. Some different Johns. John Burris Road, and the gravity sewer line will enable us to serve some developments that have come to us and requested sewer capacity. So by extending the sewer line, we'll get sewer within reach of these developments, and they'll come to us and purchase sewer capacity, which would help us pay for the project. So this opens up a pretty good area, maybe about 2,000 acres, that this line will serve. And it's much needed. We'd like to go out for bids and come back to you the next council meeting and present those bids to you for consideration.
Has the design already been drawn up for this plant?
It has. It's ready to go.
What size line are you talking about putting in, John?
In this area, along this branch, it's an 18-inch sewer line at this time. As we go up the creek, it diminishes the size. It downsizes to a 14-inch and 12 and 8 as you go further north. But it will serve a couple thousand acres in size to meet the needs of that drainage area.
Okay, got a request to advertise bids for the sit-down creek trunk line. This come out of reserve funds, and then it'll be paid back by the tap off you talked about.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
I make a motion that we advertise.
Got a motion from Willis. Have a second?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you,
John. Item 8, under announcements, July 4th activities will start July the 3rd at the fairgrounds. If you want to get a place to park, you could better get there early. Actually, they start about 6 o'clock for the 11 o'clock on July the 3rd for the fireworks. Fireworks will actually be about 9:30. And July the 4th parade will start at 10 o'clock. So invite everybody to get here early, come down, have a good time. Any other business to come for this board?
Make a motion, please.
to adjourn?
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
No, I don't. I appreciate it.